everyone, and welcome back to my video blog. Now, as I've recently reported here on my video blog, the list of companies that have been dropping Laura Ingraham's Fox News show have been growing. After doing some research, the list currently stands at Johnson & Johnson, Progressive, Miracle-Ear, Jenny Craig, Entertainment Studios, Atlantis, Principal, Stitch Fix, Hulu, Joseph A. Bank, Expedia, Nutrish, TripAdvisor, Wayfair, Nestle, Office Depot, Liberty Mutual, Ruby Tuesday, Honda, Bear, SlimFast, Blue Apron, Allstate, Mitsubishi, and the newest ones are IBM and Red Lobster. Now, it would seem to be that in this case, the worst nightmares of both Laura Ingraham and Fox News seem to be coming true, in that the advertiser boycott of Ingraham's show is continuing. And not only is it continuing, it is staying strong and going stronger as it continues. So, according to a lot of what I've read online, if the advertiser exodus from both Laura Ingraham's show and Fox News in general continue, then as I reported, in the past on here, it would eventually lead to Laura Ingraham following in the footsteps of a now former fellow Fox News colleague of hers, Bill O'Reilly. Now, something else that has made news is that the Russia Investigation Special Counsel, Bob Mueller, has apparently decided to go forward without his interview of Donald Trump. According to reports that I've read, Mueller believes he may still have enough evidence of collusion with Russia, as well as Trump obstructing justice. Now, depending upon how much longer the investigation is going to take, eventually Mueller is going to have to put together some sort of report, which he will then hand off to Congress, and it will then be Congress's decision as far as what they do with it. Now, I would think, depending on when Mueller finally gets to putting together his report, if it ends up being after the end of this year, that possibly might be a Democratic-controlled Congress that Mueller would hand off his report to. And if that happens, I would say the odds, the likelihood, the possibility of Trump getting removed from office are definitely going to be very good. In fact, I would even suggest that one of the first things that happens when Democrats retake Congress after the midterms, once Nancy Pelosi retakes her place as Speaker of the House, and Chuck Schumer replaces Harry Reid as Senate Majority Leader, I would advise that one of the very first things that Democrats do after they've taken back control of Congress would be to begin impeachment proceedings against Trump. Let's see. Other than that, well, at least here in the state of Illinois, as of today, we experienced some, fairly typical spring weather. Though, from what I've been hearing on the news, it may not actually last for very long. That, more likely than not, by Friday, temperatures may be back down again, unfortunately. So, which means even though we have been in spring for however long now, we are still somewhat getting winter weather, which is unfortunate. Well, I think that is about it for this video blog entry, this edition of my video blog. So, as usual, I would like to thank all of you for tuning into my video blog and watching this video. So, as usual, until next time, take care of yourselves and each other, and I look forward to seeing you all again next time. So until then, have a great day, everyone.